Thank you, Dr. Bhargava. It is almost, I feel very, very nostalgic in meeting you at the dais. This reminds to me date and times of early 2009. We just dreamed of the solar story. I used to meet you quite often in Eminari. And it also reminds me of, one old adage which says that, three things cannot be hidden for long: sun, moon, and truth. So glad we are at least sticking to the first part. Starting with, I'll just give you a very quick brief of who we are. We are Vikram Solar, one of the premier module manufacturer and EPC player in the country. We right now have a capacity of production of 150 megawatt. We are ramping up another 200 megawatt, which will be operational anytime soon. That would make us one of the largest players in the country as far as solar manufacturing is concerned. We are ramping up another 200 megawatt by the end of this fiscal, which would make us about 0.5 gigawatt. That would make us largest in Southeast Asia. Our plans are to ramp up to about 1.8 megawatt by 2018. And now coming to the challenges and the way how solar industry has been placed. One unique thing about Vikram Solar is over the years, how the solar story has been panned out, people have dropped their capacity. We started with a very modest capacity of around 300 megawatt, about 30 megawatt in early 2008. And from then on, to aspiring to be one of the largest in Southeast Asia by next year. While the industry on its own has either flattened or gone down, we are all the way on the way up, speaks of our own commitment to the solar. And the first part of the adage, the truth, sun and moon, and not to be encompassed. On other parts, I'll just take a tangential view from the key topic is before analyzing what we in India have in store for us, it's very important to analyze what are the key global trends that we see right now. So the global trends in solar energy right now makes renewable energy, or an alternative energy as we call it, is not an alternate anymore. It always gives me a goosebumps that we are finally becoming a globally significant source of power. We are no more alternate. I don't like this word alternate. We are an industry who are adding significant source of power in our unique way by protecting the environment. And why do we say so? The numbers itself are very, very compelling. A record amount of solar power was supplied. I'll just read out the numbers to the note that I have. The record amount of solar power was supplied to the world's grid in 2014. Cumulative capacity surged almost 100 times from the level it was in 2000. 178 gigawatt of solar power capacity we had it at the end of 2014. This is, although it is not sufficient enough in the sense that it is only about 1% of global electricity demands, but we are wrapping up and very soon we'll be 200 gigawatt globally. In 2014, renewable sources made up the majority of the new power capacity in many countries. The key investments in solar jumped 29% to almost $150 million, $149.6 billion to be precise. This is the second highest figure ever in 2014. These expenditures added unprecedented 46 gigawatt of solar PV. This is no rocket science. All of us present here and most of us who are associated with industry know that panel prices are down. We are down by 80% since 2009. I have been exposed to different kind of environment in the solar industry. I've worked with EPC players, reputed ones, and IPPs. And now also in the present capacity, I mainly look after the EPC and the IPP division in my current organization. But I have a brief overview of how these solar prices have fallen. I remember when the first bidding happened and we were talking at the first CERC guidelines were issued, we were talking about 17 and 18 rupees. And right now we just had one of the premier sponsors here, we just had a 5 rupees benchmark. So obviously, we are racing against a very, very competitive market, and which is facilitated by a global demand. Major markets which are driving the solar PV growth are obviously China, Japan, USA, and of course, India. But the good news is it's no more region-specific. It is across the world, global phenomenon. China has set up a goal to install almost 1 lakh megawatt of solar projects by 2020. Yeah, I'm talking China now. It is expected to install almost 14,000 megawatt of solar PV this year, just short of 2015 targets of 17,800. In 2014 itself, China led in terms of investment worth $83 billion in clean energy funding. Other countries which are very narrowly following China are Brazil, India, South Africa, and other African countries like Kenya, which boasts one of the largest solar rooftop systems in the continent, came across as a pleasant surprise to many of us. Let's talk US now. The US will rank third in this year for solar PV growth. It's a nearly 30% jump above 2014 levels. Just behind Japan and China, US installers will add around 8,000 megawatt of solar PV capacity. 1 lakh megawatt of renewable energy capacity that was added around the globe in 2014 is equivalent to total installed nuclear power capacity in the US. So there is a huge popularity and acceptance. Other emerging markets like Latin America, Africa, Middle East also expected to witness a surge in demand of solar projects over the next 4 to 5 years. Installation in these regions are expected to rise from about 1% of annual electricity to about 17% by 2020. So from 1% to 17%. We are right now in 2015. Just think about the kind of opportunity that is bringing to us. We are in a very, very exciting time, gentlemen. And let us all thank ourselves to be at least contributing something to the environment and to this cause. Asian nations need all markets with a whopping 86% of the world's 40 gigawatt total PV module productions at the end of the 2013, and China by itself presented 63%. Europe, for the first time ever in Europe, renewable power produced is more than the nuclear power sold, more than the nuclear. Solar is a key player. Solar contributes almost 8% and 7% to the respective annual domestic consumption in Italy and Germany. Germany is currently the world leader in solar energy and in almost 39 gigawatt of installed solar capacity. Between 2014 and 11, 70% of the new power capacity added in Europe came only from renewable resources. And let's come back to India and this remarkable initiative called Make in India. India, we all know, this data is, we are planning to generate about 1,000 gigawatt of power by 2020. This is not only a commendable effort, but also very, very ambitious, should I say audacious. Right now, as Dr. Bhargava has said, is we are at capacity of around 4 gigawatts. So from 4 to about 100 gigawatt. Obviously, the roads are not going to be easy. It's not going to be a cakewalk from here. All of us have to walk together. Now, please mark my word, walk together. That includes manufacturers, installers, key suppliers, EPC players, IPPs, DISCOMs, financial institutions, government. We have to let go all our inhibitions, small-time gains, small-time aspirations, small molecular growths. Let's target big. World is our stage. So from the 400 gigawatt to 100 gigawatt, what it means is we are actually targeting about 55% over next 8 years, investment of around US dollars and $100 billion at current prices. This would also require 5 lakh acres of land, almost half the size of Goa. No offense to the people from Goa, if there are any. Massive infrastructure is required. Like I said, we have to move together. We have to convince everybody. Okay, not many people around here have their own sense of achievement when they convince each other. But there are times when we stay helpless, especially with regards to convincing the stress of these cops. Who is going to buy these power? How is going to buy this power? 2 million. So that will be one major challenge which I see. So leaving aside the rhetoric, let us assess India's internal energy dynamics. Any objective review of the performance of the central and state electricity boards will indicate that the country is facing serious concerns to connect nearly one-third of the population to electricity grids. So far, so long, we are still two-thirds of that do not receive reliable continuous supply. We are the third largest producers of the electricity, gentlemen, with almost 271 gigawatt of installed generating capacity. But our per capita consumption is only 684 kilowatt in 2011. We have been power deficit in decades, gentlemen, decades. Major reason of deficient is obviously, one of the major reasons is insufficient transmission capacity. 24% of the generated electricity is lost each year during transmission and distribution. 24%. If we want to target 100 gigawatt and all these plans that we have built for ourselves, this number has to go down. This number cannot stay at it is. Let's take a very quick view on what our rural India brings us. One in three, every Indian rely on sources like kerosene, diesel, biomass. In India, you would be surprised to know that the Global Burden of Disease report says that indoor air pollution ranks second and outdoor pollution fifth among silent killers. An OECD study says that 12% rise in the mortality rate in India attributes to air pollution and estimate that cost of society of this air pollution is estimated $500 billion. We are talking about a problem here, and solar is a problem. Unless we agree together, unless we have the sanity to walk together and try to address the challenges as a whole, we can't move forward. But this is not a day of gloom, this is a day of hope. We are all in a country where there's a lot of, like Dr. Bhagava said, there's a lot of sanity in the policy front. We have a naval leadership, very, very progressive. And I'm reminded of good days ahead. And I guess with that view in mind, harnessing 100 gigawatt solar energy will not be too difficult. All the more, this will bring so many jobs, almost 1 million new jobs. So thank you all, gentlemen. I look forward to hear your work.